Hey guys, thanks for tuning in today to the Calvary's Word of Encouragement, and I'm Pastor Jeff. I have one of my favorite passages of Scripture that I'd like to read some of it to you today. I'm not going to read the whole chapter, but it's Psalms 103. And the Bible says in Psalms 103, starting in verse 1, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgives all thine iniquities, who heals all thy diseases, who redeems thy life from destruction, who crowns thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, and who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles." And that's Psalms 103, verses 1 through 5. You know, when we were talking about doing the words of encouragement and having a time to come to you guys every day or two to have these times together with you, and I'm very proud of my staff for taking time out to do that, and I hope you guys have enjoyed not just hearing from me, but from hearing from them as well. But when we started talking about this, we wanted to take some scripture that had a specific meaning to us as Christians and to us as some believers, that's something that we could share with you. And for me, this psalm is one of those verses. It's been underlined in every Bible that I've ever owned that I've used, because it's one of those places that for me is a sweet reminder of all that God has done and is doing and is going to do in my life. But go back and let's think about the very first verse. The Bible says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name." Our first remembrance is of Him and His holy name. Now, how easy it is for us to get hung up on an answered prayer list, or how easy it is for us to get hung up on the things that He has done for us, and sometimes to forget the God behind the blessings, or the God behind the answers, or the heart of the God behind the blessings. And I want to say to us, Lord, help us to remember Him. And I want to say to you today, take some time today to just simply think on who He is and what all that He has done. The next verse says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits." Now, I could, and I think many of you could too, if we were to start a testimony time right now and just have people to line up across here and talk about all the ways that God has heard and answered prayers and all the ways that God has come through for us and all the things that God has done for us in our lives, I think it would be a very long testimony time, because that's how good and that's how gracious God has been to us. So I'll ask you this. Have you, in the midst of everything that's going on, and there's an awful lot, okay, in the midst of everything that's happening around us, and again, there's from day to day that changes, and the forecast of everything changes from day to day. But I want to tell you something today. Let's not just be so focused on that we forget who our God is. And let's not just be so focused on all of that we forget all that our God has already done for us. And dear friend, He has not forsaken us, and He's not going to forsake us now. So we remember who He is. We remember all that He has done. And then David gives us something else here in Psalms 103. He said, verse 3, he said, "Who forgives all of your iniquities and heals all of your diseases." Now, I'm not going to have time to develop all of these thoughts, but I just want to say one of the sweetest words in the Bible to me is the word forgiveness. Is the word forgiveness. And over in the New Testament, the Jesus, when dealing with somebody who was in trouble, and He would say, "Your sins are forgiven you." And then if you go on over, and I believe it's in Romans, that our sins are forgiven us for Christ's sake. I mean, and then in 1 John 1:9-10, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. It's one of those words that is just amazing to me to hear. And the concept of forgiveness is just amazing when you think that it is about God who forgives us our iniquities. Forgiveness. Thank God for forgiveness. I have experienced the forgiveness of God. Have you? Have you ever had Him to forgive you and start you over? Have you ever had Him forgive you and stand you back up? Have you ever had Him to forgive you? And I want to tell you something. Forgiveness is not based on a feeling. Forgiveness is based on the fact of the Word of God. God ain't nothing to do about feeling forgiven. Anyway, that's another message to preach. But think about this just for a second. Bless him for who he is. Bless him for what he has done. And thank him for the benefits that he pours out in our lives. Thank you for tuning in today. I hope you have a good day. And I hope that you'll listen to the other words of encouragement that'll be coming from our team this week. Thank you and have a good day.